Last stop on Market Street. CJ pushed through the church doors, skipped down the steps. The outside air smelled like freedom, but it also smelled like rain, which freckled CJ's shirt and dripped down his nose. He ducked under his Nana's umbrella, saying, "How come we gotta wait for the bus in all this wet?" "Trees get thirsty too," his Nana told him. "Don't you see that big one drinking through a straw?" CJ looked for a long time, but he never saw the straw. From the bus, he watched water pool on water flower petals, watched rain patter against the windshield of a nearby car. His friend Colby climbed in, gave CJ a wave, and drove off with his dad. "Nana, how come we don't got a car?" "Boy, what do we need a car for? We got a bus that breathes fire and old Mr. Dennis who always has a trick for you." The bus creaked to a stop in front of them. It sighed and sagged and the door swung open. "What's that I see?" Mr. Dennis asked. He pulled a coin from behind CJ's ear and placed it in his palm. Nana laughed her deep laugh and pushed CJ along. They sat right up front. The man across the way was tuning a guitar. An old woman with curlers had butterflies in a jar. Nana gave everyone a great big smile and a good afternoon. She made sure CJ did the same. The bus lurched forward and stopped, lurched forward and stopped. Nana hummed as she knit. "How come we always gotta go here after church?" CJ said. "Miguel and Colby never have to go nowhere." "I feel sorry for those boys," she told him. "They'll never get a chance to meet Bobo or Sunglass Man. And I hear Trixie got herself a brand new hat." CJ stared out the window, feeling sorry for himself. He watched cars zip by on either side, watched a group of boys hop curbs on bikes. A man climbed aboard with a spotted dog. CJ gave up his seat. "How come that man can't see?" "Boy, what do you know about seeing?" Nana told him. "Some people watch the world with their ears." "That's a fact. Their noses, too," the man said, sniffing the air. "That's a mighty fine perfume you're wearing today, ma'am." Nana squeezed the man's hand and laughed her deep laugh. Two older boys got on next. CJ watched as they moved on by and stood him back. "Sure wish I had one of those," he said. Nana set down her knitting. "What for? You got the real live thing sitting across from you. Why don't you ask that man if he'll play us a song?" CJ didn't have to ask. The guitar player was already plucking strings and beginning to sing. "To feel the magic of music," the blind man whispered. "I like to close my eyes." Nana closed hers too. So did CJ and the spotted dog. And in the darkness of the rhythm lifted CJ out of the bus, out of the busy city. He saw sunset colors swirling over crashing waves, saw a family of hawks slicing through the sky, saw the old woman's butterflies dancing free in the light of the moon. CJ's chest grew full and he was lost in the sound, and the sound gave him the feeling of magic. The song ended and CJ opened his eyes. Everyone on the bus clapped, even the boys in the back. Nana glanced at the coin in CJ's palm. He dropped it in the man's hat. "Last stop on Market Street," Mr. Dennis called. CJ looked around as he stepped off the bus. Crumbling sidewalks and broken down doors, graffiti-tagged windows and boarded up stores. He reached for Nana's hand. "How come it's always so dirty over here?" She smiled and pointed to the sky. "Sometimes when you're surrounded by dirt, CJ, you're a better witness to what is beautiful." CJ saw the perfect rainbow arching over their soup kitchen. He wondered how his Nana always found beautiful where he never even thought to look. He looked all around them again, at the bus rounding the corner out of sight, and the broken street lamp still lit up bright, and the stray cat shadow moving across the wall. When he spotted their familiar faces in the window, he said, "I'm glad we came." He thought his Nana might laugh her deep laugh, but she didn't. She patted him on the head and told him, "Me too, CJ. Now come on." Hey, Bluffton families. I hope that you enjoyed Last Stop on Market Street. You know, I love this book because it's one of these ones that I feel like you can read it multiple times, and every single time you read it or you listen to it, each time you walk away with a different lesson or a different idea walking away from the book. And that's why I think it's like a complex children's book. I don't know about you all, but since school has ended and now sports are starting back up here in Bluffton, I know my family, we've been out and about a lot more, and we even went to the beach one day at Hilton Head, but we've been around Bluffton and we've been taking walks and bike rides. And you know, I love the message in this book that to look for things that are beautiful, right? I really challenge you this coming week or weekend to take the opportunity to be in familiar places, but really stop and try to take in the beauty and the majesty that God has created for us to enjoy here on earth. It's pretty remarkable. And not just to take in the beauty of the things and in your surroundings, but also to take in the beauty of the people and how different and diverse and how much we all have something special to offer in this world, and also how much you have to offer in this world. I miss you guys, and I can't wait to see you. I feel like our time has been so long apart from each other, but think about how much we're gonna have to share with one another when we do come back together. All right, take care.